Can you imagine a giant excavator the size of a five-story building? It's hard to believe that these monsters are built by humans and have not been sent to us from another planet. This is Caterpillar 6090FS, the largest and most powerful hydraulic excavator in the world, that was designed for series production. This machine has a maximum digging height of 66 feet, and its operating weight is 980 tons. It is equipped with the latest CAT technology features, including digital monitoring systems and real-time tracking. But was this mining excavator always wearing yellow paint and had Caterpillar decals on its body? Let's find out. The story of this machine goes back to 1995, when Syncrude Canada, one of the world's largest producers of synthetic crude oil from oil sands, formed a cooperation with Orenstein and Koppel, O&K. They joined forces and started development of the largest hydraulic front shovel in the world, which was named RH400. Although the well-established cable shovels had their advantages, RH400 offered greater mobility and a lower initial price. Its cost was right around $7 million, while some of the largest cable machines were in the neighborhood of $10 million. As the machine was intended to work in northern Alberta during its harsh winter months, special attention had to be paid to the bucket design, car body, and hydraulic systems. In July 1997, the prototype was officially unveiled at the O&K Dortmund facility in Germany. This was a huge milestone for Orenstein and Koppel, which put it ahead of Demag, the manufacturer of the former largest hydraulic shovel in the world. Since that time, RH400 has become monumental in the mining industry, and more than a decade after this machine was launched, it was even CGI'd for one of the Transformers movies. After all the factory testing at the Dortmund facility was done, the machine was disassembled and shipped to Canada in August 1997. Once on site at Syncrude, the RH400 was reassembled by the same O&K team from Germany in a record 10 days. Now was the time for the massive 910-ton hydraulic excavator to show its new owners what it could do. A few months after, in December 1997, nearly at the time when Syncrude approved the purchase of the second unit, O&K announced that it was selling its mining division to Terex, an American mining equipment company based in Tulsa, Oklahoma. But other than the corporate colors, there were no major changes. The RH400 excavators were still built in Dortmund, as were all the other O&K mining machines. From that time on, up until the end of 2009, all RH400s, including the first two units, will be referred to as Terex O&K RH400. During that period, at least 9 units were manufactured and shipped to different customers across the globe. This is another unit that was also built for one of the oil sand mines in Canada. This time, for a different customer, CNRL, Canadian Natural Resources Limited, one of the country's major oil and gas companies. This unit had a few upgrades compared to the first two machines, which included the longer boom and stick to extend the machine's overall working reach. Also, a new undercarriage with wider tracks was installed to lessen the RH400's ground pressure. This unit here was purchased by CITIC Pacific Mining, the developer and operator of mining, processing, and port operations in Western Australia. This RH400 is working on its flagship project, the largest magnetite mining and processing operation in Australia, supplying high-quality magnetite iron ore to steel mills in China. In December 2009, Terex sold its mining equipment business to Bucyrus RH400 for $1.3 billion. The new owner was one of the major American surface and underground mining equipment companies based in South Milwaukee, Wisconsin. RH400 was again rebranded, receiving the new corporate colors. This ownership, though, did not last long. In July 2011, another big acquisition happened in the heavy equipment industry.
Mining equipment stocks are gaining attention after Caterpillar said it was buying mining equipment manufacturer Bucyrus International for $7.6 billion.
As of today, that was the final rebranding of RH400. From that time on, the previously built machines would keep the original color trims, but Caterpillar would own the rights to them. The new units would be manufactured under the name CAT 6090FS and have the famous Caterpillar yellow paint. In its current version, CAT 6090FS is a 980-ton hydraulic shovel. It is powered either by two Cummins diesel engines, with a total output of 4,500 horsepower, or by highly efficient electric motors, which provide a lower cost per ton performance, an output of 3,200 kilowatts, or 4,291 horsepower. Its height to the top of the cab is 24 feet 6 inches, and its boom can be raised to the height of a 5-story building. This 46-ton Liebherr excavator standing beside the CAT 6090 looks like a Mini Cooper beside a dump truck. The fuel tank of this machine has 4,000 gallons of capacity. With the current gas prices, it would cost almost $20,000 to fill up this tank in the US. Even having such an enormous weight, this monster is capable of moving with a maximum speed of 1.37 miles per hour. The maximum shovel capacity of this machine is 52 cubic meters or 68 cubic yards. It takes four very quick passes to load the 363-ton capacity Caterpillar 797. The operator's compartment, along with the latest state-of-the-art controls and diagnostic systems, has an adjacent lunchroom with all the comforts of home, including clothes lockers, microwave, water dispenser, coffee machine, toaster oven, and a refrigerator. During long 12-hour shifts, often in remote areas of the mine, and especially during the winter months, these conveniences become essential for the operator. Counting from the time when it was first unveiled in Dortmund under the name O&K RH400, this marvel of the mining industry celebrated its 25th anniversary in July 2022. Since 1997, a few other hydraulic shovels with similar capacities have been put into series production, but none of them could become as large as the mighty RH400, 6090FS. This was the largest and most powerful hydraulic excavator in the world that was designed for series production. Thanks for watching this video to the end, we hope that you liked it. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel.